Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our lesson, that is matter around us pure? Students, we have seen various separation techniques for heterogeneous mixtures. So today we are going to talk about the mixture which is homogeneous. Means today we are going to see the separation technique for the homogeneous mixture. So you are knowing homogeneous mixture means a true solution, means two liquids or two components when mixed with each other, which we are unable to identify them as well as we are unable to separate them very easily. Such mixtures are called as a homogeneous mixture, means both are in a same form. We have seen everything related to homogeneous mixture. So here what we are going to do, this technique we are going to follow for the homogeneous mixture, means two components are mixed with each other. So homogeneous mixture means the solutions are mixing with each other. Such liquids or such solutions are called as a miscible liquids. See students, yesterday we have talked about immiscible liquids, means there were two solutions which were unable to dissolve with each other, okay, and for that sake we used a separating funnel method, students. But now we are going to see some different method to separate the homogeneous mixture. So before going ahead, I would like to clear the concept for you, that is evaporation and condensation, because basically this technique is depend simple distillation technique. So first I would like to note that which technique we are going to follow to separate two immiscible liquids or a homogeneous mixture. Which technique we are going to follow? That is simple distillation method or process we are going to follow for what? Two miscible liquids, means the solutions are combined with each other or mixed with each other. So here one word I shall explain you: distillation or simple distillation method. Students, this technique is mainly depend on the two process, that is evaporation and condensation. Students, you are knowing evaporation means what? The process of change, the process of change of liquid into gaseous state at any temperature below its boiling point is called as a evaporation. And condensation is exactly opposite of it. Condensation is what? Whenever the vapors are getting cold climate, whenever the vapors are getting cold climate, hot vapors are getting cold climate, immediately what happens? They turn into back liquid state. Means exactly this process are opposite to each other. This continuous condensation and evaporation causes rainfall. We are quite well known about it. We are knowing very well the rainfall causes or precipitation is causes due to the continuous evaporation and condensation. So condensation is exactly opposite of evaporation. Evaporation we know. Condensation, what happens whenever the vapors are getting cold climate, these vapors are again converting back into the liquid state or the water if we are using water. See in distillation method, see here students, with very simple example I would like to know you distillation method. See whenever we are not feeling well, we drink water while by boiling, right? Nowadays also we are drinking, because of this pandemic situation we are drinking water by boiled. So what you do, or your mother would do, she's taking one utensil, small utensil, and allowing it to boil that liquid. She's allowing it to boil, understood? And after sometimes what happens, whenever that liquid boils and then she stops giving heat, she stops providing heat, and the water is covered. And after some time, after that pot is getting cold, if we will try to observe the lower part of that lid, or of the particle of the lid, of the lower part of that lid, if you will see, then you will see small water droplets over it. From where these water droplets have gathered? See what happens, I will explain you properly. Whenever the water would boil, means water will turn into the vapor state, and that vapor state, then water will accumulate. If suppose this is the plate, then at the bottom you will see small droplets. From where this water has come now? Because you have given heat, and because of heat the water has turned into vapor state. But whenever this vapor state has got a cold climate, that water converts into again back into the liquid state, means water water vapor turns into the vapor form. That we have seen condensation process. Suppose if you are taking out our bottle, chilled bottle from the fridge, and if we'll keep for a while, after some time you can see small droplets out on the surface of the of that bottle. From where this small droplets have come? Because whenever the air which is present into the atmosphere, that air, whenever it is getting cold climate, that vapor turns into the water vapor. So here also same thing had happened. The vapor was there, and whenever that vapor becomes cool, that vapor turn into water droplet. So on this concept only we are going to see the simple distillation method. But for the simple distillation method, one thing we have to keep in mind, there are two types of distillation method, students. A simple distillation method and another is fractional distillation method. Then what is the main difference between it? Students, we are knowing there is a boiling point of water, that is 100 degree Celsius. The boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius. And you are knowing alcohol and water can mix with each other. Understood? Means we are unable to identify. If there would be color, different color, then only we can come to know that alcohol is added. Otherwise, if colorless any solution would be there which can easily dissolve into the water, we are unable to understand that any other solvent is also dissolved into the water. Why? Because water is colorless and its boiling point is 100 degree Celsius. And we will take another example, that is of alcohol, pure alcohol. If we will take, it has boiling point of 78 degree Celsius. Okay, students, you got the concept. This is the boiling point of water, that is 100 degree Celsius. And this is the boiling point of alcohol, that is 78 degree Celsius. So if we want to separate the two components from the miscible solution, then there is one important condition, that the temperature difference, means boiling point difference, it should be of 25 degree Celsius. Means between two liquids, the difference should be of 25 degree Celsius. If this difference would not be maintained, then by simple distillation method, we cannot separate the liquids, two different liquids, because 25 degree Celsius temperature is required for simple distillation process. So this condition can be fulfilled by this solution, that is of water and the alcohol. So alcohol has 100 degree Celsius and alcohol has 78 degree Celsius. So this condition, or this liquid, miscible liquid we can say, which can mix with each other. So this miscible liquid can be separated by simple distillation method, because the difference between it is somewhere near to the 25 degree Celsius. So how does exactly this process work? See, students, what will happen? If you will try to mix them together, then they will properly mix with each other. Okay, then what will happen? And if you will try providing heat for them, for both the liquids, if we'll try, because they are completely mixed with each other, then what will happen? If we'll try to provide heat for them, then what will happen? As the boiling point of alcohol is 78 degree Celsius, which will first evaporate. Here the concept of evaporation you should know, because the water will convert into vapor, or any other liquid will convert first into the volatile liquids, or volatile concept you are knowing. Volatile means the thing which can evaporate earlier, that is called as a volatile substance. So if you will take these two substances and we will allow it to boil, these two this homogeneous mixture, that is miscible mixtures, if we will allow it to boil, then first which of this will boil first? You are absolutely right. 78 degree Celsius, whenever there, if we will put insert in that, I will explain you that also. If we'll put inside one thermometer, then whenever that solution will reach at the 78 degree Celsius, immediately what will happen? Alcohol will turn into the vapors, and we will have such arrangement that through there will be one pipe, so the vapors of the alcohol will get accumulate into one distillation, means that is there will be one arrangement in that pipe that all vapors of the alcohol will get accumulated. But when we will get vapors, we cannot collect. So what we have to do, we have to do some arrangement, that cold water arrangement we have to do. So whenever those vapors of alcohol will get a cold climate, immediately that cold, that vapor of the alcohol will turn into the alcohol immediately. Vapor of the alcohol, whenever they are getting the cold water or cold water beside it, if the atmosphere will be cold, then what will happen? That alcohol vapor will be turned into the pure alcohol. Okay, and now what will happen means at the 78 degrees Celsius, all the alcohol vapors will be gathering into that arrangement. But and the remaining solution, means remaining solution of water will be into the same flask. So in this manner the simple distillation method will be working. So here there is one exam, you can see students, there is one clamp or the stand is arranged, right? And on that stand you can see one distillation flask, means you can see there is one tripod stand, you have seen various times. So there is one tripod stand, above it wire gauze is there, and above it one distillation flask, means the apparatus in which we are going to keep mixture, that is called as a distillation flask. Okay, and there is one Bunsen burner through which we are going to provide heat. And for that distillation flask, you can see there is one tube like structure. That tube like structure will be having the water vapor which will come out first. Okay, and that tube will be surrounded by the cold water, because that vapor should get a cold climate. And at the end of that tube there will be some collector. Okay, whatever the liquid we will get, that liquid we will collect into one collector. Okay, so there will be any utensil, maybe any round bottom flask or anything else, or simple beaker also can be kept. So that will be accumulated. So students, in this arrangement, if you will see, if you will try providing heat, then what will happen? The solution will start spoiling, and as we are going to put one thermometer in it to see the temperature, okay? So what will happen when the water will start boiling, means all that solution, whenever it will start boiling and the temperature will reach at 78 degrees Celsius, that time what will happen? The alcohol which is dissolved in it, as its boiling point is 78 degrees Celsius, it will first accumulate into that arrangement, means that pipe like structure it will get, means all that vapors will get accumulate into that arrangement. And as it is surrounded by the cold water frequently, then that liquid vapors will get convert into the liquid, and that will accumulate into that collector or any utensil. And at the same time, whatever the liquid will be remaining into that distillation flask, that is our water. So this is the method which we follow for the simple distillation method. This is called as a simple distillation method which we follow for the two miscible liquids. Miscible liquids means which liquids which can mix with each other, and the temperature difference in between them should be of 25 degrees Celsius. Otherwise this technique will not be followed. Then students, if this technique is not followed, means if 25 degrees Celsius difference will not be there, and then to it if it is miscible liquids, then which technique we follow? That technique we will see tomorrow, and that is called as a fractional distillation method. That technique is quite different from this technique. So I hope you understand this technique, that is simple distillation method.